a few months after joined Kala Bhavan, one of my friends who had the enthusiasm to exhibit works of these people in UP in one of the exhibitions thought that he should get them to agree to exhibit in Delhi. They hadn't had an exhibition in Delhi. So he said that he had an uncle almost his own sort of age. And he planned the whole thing and persuaded them that they will lend their works and they will do. Then he talked to me, since you can talk in English a little better than I, why don't you come with me? So I went with him to Delhi with this exhibition. And in planning the whole exhibition, getting together all the works and doing, I came a little closer to them. And I saw their works much more than most other people saw. And of course, our experience in Delhi was also very educative. In 1945, there wasn't much of an art activity in Delhi. In Delhi at that time, the old Delhi and New Delhi, you have to reach by those horse carts, tongas, this sort of thing. And it seemed quite far. And then the culture of New Delhi and Old Delhi were also different, very official, very... And then the main art exhibition in those days was the art exhibitions that the different societies had, which was mostly academic work. The other people who had shown Delhi at that time was Sharada Ukil, who had an Ukil School of Art, and Amrita Shergil. In fact, Amrita Shergil charmed Sharada Ukil's brother, Baruda Ukil, to almost go along with her, and they used to have a few exhibitions together. So in her letters, she laughs at the kind of the thing he had to do that. Anyway, she was known, and the other artist known at that time was a product of Kala Bhavan, but who used to be in the Doon School as an art teacher, that is Sudhir Khastagir. These were the people were familiar with at that time. So when Benode Bihari's and Ramkinar's work went there, Benode Bihari had said that, you see, I don't know many people anywhere, but I know Nirad Chaudhuri, and you can go and meet him. So we went and met Nirad Chaudhuri. He was then the script writer in the All India Radio, especially news and other items and things like that. We went and met him, that, look, we are going to have this exhibition. Benode Bihari apparently knows you. Will you be helpful to us? He was very forthcoming. He said, I'll write a small note for your leaflet. Then he even took us to dinner, or even to his house in Kashmiri Gate. Then showed us his library of art books and things of that kind. Well, he had not become the man he became later as a sort of a all-knowing sort of a, yeah, but he was very nice. Then
was that before he wrote the autobiography of an unknown Indian?
Ah, that's right. That's much before. Yeah. So then he said, this kind of a work, you can't just show like that. Here, no exhibition sort of attracts people unless it is opened by somebody. So we were wondering who will do that. Then he himself suggested Zakir Hussain, who at that time was the Vice Chancellor of the Jamia Millia Islamia. He is sort of a man with a lot of knowledge about the world and also interested in art. So why don't you go and ask him? So we tried to contact Zakir Hussain, and Zakir Hussain said that I ought to see the paintings. I'll be very happy. I have heard about artists in EA, but I haven't seen any of their work. So we had to go in a tonga all the way, so many kilometers, to his place to show it. And in the meanwhile, we had to find a place where to show them. The only two sort of a, not gallery spaces there was one was owned by the All India Fine Arts and Crafts Society. And another was a smaller place called Freemasons Hall at that time. But in the All India Fine Arts and Crafts Society, they didn't approve of the work. They said that we can't show this work. So we were quite...
So there was no Lalit Kala?
No Lalit Kala, nothing at all. This is in 45. Lalit Kala came into being about 7 or 8 years later. So while walking along, we saw the YMCA, which had a big hall. And I went in, and then it was the administrator of the whole thing was a man from Kerala. So I talked to him and said that this is the thing. Is there any space where we can? So he said, we have a kind of a hall, but nobody exhibits works here. But in the, I can give you on a certain date, yes. You can fix the date with that, but then you cannot put any nails on the wall. So, and it had too many windows. So I said, look, we will have to put some kind of a battens and nails at the end and have jute canvas, say, so that it looks like a proper exhibition hall. He agreed to that. So the date was fixed. So we went and told Dr. Hussain, can he come and open? He saw the paintings and he was quite favorably impressed and he said, I would very much like to do it, but I'm not there on that day, I'm going to Germany. So then I said, if you're going away, does he have any suggestions of who? He said, well, I don't know who is interested in art these days and things of that kind. And especially if you can, then he suddenly said, there is a person called, Edward Benthall. Who then was the member secretary of the railway board. He said, he may not know anything about art, but he's a perfect gentleman. And he's well thought of by everyone in Delhi, so why don't you call him? So we went to Edward Benthall. He was very nice. He was a tall Englishman, very proper. And he said, I'll agree, I know nothing about art. But all the same, I am sure that when you have come all the way to show these works should be of some importance. Then there was the opening. And because Edward Benthall opened them, well, a lot of people came to see it. And especially the people from the then Delhi Art School, which was not an art school at that time. It was a Delhi Polytechnic, where it had an art department. And then the statesmen sent its critics over. That was Charles Fabrier was the critic. And it had a kind of a good reception. Now, this is how I came close to them and through these things. Of course, those days, I mean, we just made the money we spent on it by selling two paintings of each. And that was bought by the art department of the A. Otherwise, there was nothing else. Art department of the Delhi Polytechnic. In fact, what is now called Delhi College of Art, it was at that time the art department of the Delhi Polytechnic.